So today we're going to talk about some changes that have occurred in Marlin firmware. This is a supplemental that I wanted to show everyone because we've run into some issues where people have had trouble with some of the tutorials. So I'm on marlinfirmware.org or marlinfw.org. And I want to show you quickly how to do this. So I'm going to click on the download and I'm going to download that to my downloads folder. Now, while that's downloading, I'm going to show you release notes real quick. There have been a lot of new features that have been added, as well as new machine boards. And then we also have configuration updates, and then optimized and improved. These are some of the things that have occurred in the actual Marlin firmware that you need to be aware of because these changes have taken place. And so some of my actual configurations that I've shown have been not precise. So I'm going to go quickly over to the desktop for a moment, and I'm going to extract this by clicking on Extract All. And then I'm going to extract them. So while that's occurring, I'm going to actually open up VS Code and it might pop up over it. So I'm going to minimize that for a second. This will take a few moments to actually extract depending upon your computer. So I'm going to go over to Marlin in VS Code now and show you some of the changes. Now, this is an actual old version, so I'm going to close the folder and I'm actually going to open up the new one as soon as it completes, which it just has. So I'm going to go to the Explorer, which is in the upper left-hand corner. I'm going to open the folder. I'm going to go to my Downloads folder, my Marlin folder, and my Next Marlin folder. Then I'm going to select the folder. And as you can see, there are a lot of new changes that you can see up here. This looks like a developer change for Docker. I'm not going to cover that in this tutorial because it may not be relevant, but I'm going to talk about some of the new things like docs. It looks like they put docs in here to show us things about our basic algorithms and how they may work. I'm not going to cover this too much because it depends on your actual printer, but you can actually look at the logic of what they're talking about. Queuing, on the other hand, is kind of important. This is how your G codes will be interpreted by your processor. So there's a host, that would be your computer. Then there's the RxTx buffer size, that depends upon your serial's buffer. And then there's the Marlin queue of serial commands that come in for movement on your printer with G codes. These are the basic outline of how your G codes are handled. And then they talk about serial, but they also say that it won't be addressed until 2.0.9. And seeing how we're on 2.0.8, I'm going to leave that for the moment. The other thing they have changed is the INI structure, and this has to do with your build process. As you can see, the AVR.INI is actually your 8-bit processors, and all the rest, I believe, are 32-bit processors, but I'm sure that there may be other configurations that I may be missing. So I'm going to talk about this one right now in a second. But I'm also going to show you about the Marlin auto build or auto build Marlin. To install this, all you have to do is click on extensions and type Marlin. And in my case, it's already installed, so I'm not going to uninstall it, but you have the option to install it when you have that opportunity. But for now, I'm just going to talk about it briefly and show you what's going on. So the other thing I want to tell you is if you don't have the environment that looks like mine, please follow the install video that I'll put up in the upper right hand corner for installing VS Code. This will make your life a lot simpler. But for now, we're going to talk about the actual configuration. So I'm going to click on the Explorer again so I can see the configurations. And I'm going to show you first Marlin Auto Build and point out the drawbacks and also the advantages of it. So in Platform IO, our default chipset is the Mega 2560. That's the chipset for the ramps configuration. It was one of the very first configurations that were used for Marlin. So it's always there. So I'm going to show you under Marlin Source Core Boards.h that these are all the new configurations. And normally I use the name of the configuration, not the number, but you can use the number. It's preferable to use the name. That's just an association between the two. So what I want to first show you though is in Marlin's configuration.h, if you go to motherboard by searching on it, you can see that the ramps configuration is the default and the chipset for that is the Mega 2560. Notice how it's zero for the actual load. That's because it's directly connected and has a different way of loading versus 32-bit. So what I want to do is first show you the compile in Marlin Auto Build. So I'm going to click on it. I'm going to click on Show ABM Panel. And in here, it says the Mega 2560 or the Mega 1280. That was a different chipset. We're currently on this one, and they also have configuration tools. Now the tools are not implemented yet, so you're gonna see configuration tool under construction for all of them. That's because it's not ready yet. But I'm gonna show you how to do the Marlin Auto Build real quick. You're just gonna click Build, and it will build your configuration. Now keep in mind that if you see an error with your first build, there might be something out of order in the actual Marlin configuration for the build, so build a second time. If you don't see that, that's great, but if you see it after the second time, correct the very first error that you see, because the other ones are caused by a cascade of errors off that. So now that we've actually done a build, the advantage to this is if you want to see the last build in the actual folder, it'll pop up and show you the build. Now note, this is in hexadecimal. It's not a binary, so it loads slightly different, and that has to do with the very first command that's probably in the file. So let me see if I can see it here. It might be a code up here. I'm not sure which one it is off the top of my head, but that is how it prepares the processor for a new load. So the same thing probably occurs with our configuration, but it's a binary and it's pointed to on the 32-bit configurations, usually to an SD drive. You can also load it remotely, but we'll talk about that some other time. So I'm gonna go back here and I'm actually gonna set this up under Source Core Boards.h for one of the most popular boards being the SKR_14. And this will show us the configurations. Sorry, that's V14. And this configuration right here is actually for the Marlin with the processor LPC1768. Now, the turbo version is actually down here. So we're going to do the turbo version of the SKR. So I'm going to copy that. I'm then going to close out of boards.h. I'm going to go back to Marlin configuration.h. I'm going to highlight the ramps and paste that over it. Now the actual serial port, we're going to change to -1. And to build this, we have obviously several ways to do it, but I'm going to use the checkbox in this case because I don't have a board connected. On the ramps, You can use the forward arrow for the default, as well as the SKR14 if it's connected to the computer and is not in a failed state. But we're going to use the build for now. So I'm going to click on this, but before I do that, I need to show you a couple of things. First, the .pio folder. There's our last build for the Mega 2560. This may cause issues with your build, so do a clean to get that out of there. That's the little garbage can down here. Next, we have to set the platform.io.ini, and our chipset for this is going to be different. So we have to go to the INI folder because they're all linked in here by directory of INI versus the board that we're working with. In this case, we're using the LPC1768, but there will be other processors, which I'll show you in just a second. So I'm going to select for our default processor LPC1768. In this case, it's actually 1769 because we're using the turbo. Pardon me for that. And I'm going to click the build button. While that's building, it's only going to take about 20 seconds. I'm going to talk about the other ones over here. So there are other boards that may be listed that you're using for Marlin. If you find the default environment for those, you'll have to go through each one of these folders and see if you can find it. So in this case, there's not a lot in here except for the Bigtree Tech SKR Pro that applies to the SKR 1.1 and 1.2. But they're sprinkled throughout these folders. You would take that and you would actually copy it, and then you would paste it into your default environment right here. But seeing how we just did the LPC1769 for the SKR Turbo, we're not going to do it again. But that's the process that's recently changed. So at this point, I want to thank everybody for watching. And I will roll credits for the patrons that have recently signed up, because apparently it's increased by about 150% this month. So I will have credits rolling. So I just want to say thank you for taking the time to watch my tutorial, and be safe, wear a mask, and have a nice day.